bullshit all the time. We've done many, many interviews where we say nothing but the truth. It's because you get bored doing interviews and you say stupid stuff and then you regret it afterwards, and people come up to you and they go like, is it true that you're a carpenter? There's a rumor going around that David, who I play with, is my brother. It's not true. He's adopted.
The most common one is that I'm two people, which, as you can see, I am not. I read an amazing, there was a thread on a blog, and somewhat it was basically just laying into me for the fact that I've remixed a few classics in my time, and some guy said on the blog, all Funkagenda does is sample the original record and then cheese up the kick. I have no idea what that means, but apparently that's how I make my remixes. I cheese up the kick.
Like, I'm too techno, I'm too house, I'm a diva, I'm not a diva, I'm a bad DJ, I'm a good DJ, you know? I think this whole industry is just about people talking about each other and talking shit all the time. That's what is cool in the end, you know? That's how stories happen.
In Ibiza. Somebody told me an amazing story. It's nothing to do with me, but maybe this is not a true story, but it's a story about space, about the... Somebody told me that in the... I think it's the 80s or the end of the 70s, when the terrace was open, they had a guy, a German guy, who had a private plane, and he had underneath the plane, Love is in the Air, and then he made a deal with the DJ that when he would fly over, they would play Lovers in the Air and they would circle around twice and people would look up and they had like Lovers in the Air on the plane. I want to believe it.
Actually, tell you the truth, first time I came to Ibiza, I just didn't know anything about Ibiza except that my father came here during the 60s. But he was a hippie, so
cool.
Yeah. So when I told him that I was coming, he was like, oh yeah, I went there in the 60s, really cool. And I was playing for one of the first cocoon parties. So that was kind of the beginning of my career, you know, so I really didn't know what to expect. And when I saw that whole mess, I was like, oh shit, what the hell is that? So, but you know, at the time Ibiza was more of a very dedicated people. So.
All the stories that I'd heard of Ibiza came from all my friends who were kind of like veterans. They'd been coming here from like, you know, since 1995, 96, like, you know, and so I heard all this amazing stuff about the clubs and, you know, how enormous they are and blah, 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 blah. And, you know, they are, they're big, but, you know, the way I was imagining it, like every single one of them could fit like a jumbo jet in it. And, you know, it was just kind of this ridiculous people climbing over people, massive of hysteria in every club. And actually, when you get here, you know, a lot of it's quite civilized, and you know, there's a lot of standing around and drinking and
horrible. I had a feeling that it was like I remember the first time we came here, it was everything I hated about dance music, I thought. And then the more we came, the more I started getting into this whole Ibiza, the history of it, and even in the 60s and the 70s, and how people would come here and how music was part of that, and it became really interesting, and I would understand that this island more and more is like a bit of a refuge for people who are a bit eccentric and don't find, like, it could be anything, yeah. And that kind of makes it a crazy island. You always come and you always go like, oh, I'm gonna stay in, I'm not gonna do anything, but you end up going out, you end up meeting people. I have a double feeling with it because it's so about money and about clubs and clubbing, and it's like DJ magazine, there's a whole culture around it. But on the other hand, there's another level, something else. Thank you.
mean, that was why I switched from CDJs, because bored. Like, I used to play on them all, on them. I played on them since like the 90s. And, you know, once you can mix on them, that's it, you know. And it got to the point I was asking for three CDJs, then four CDJs. And then I was like, I can't put a fifth CDJ on my rider. This is ridiculous. So I'm going to move all into a computer. You see a lot of advertisement for DJs doing, like, say, six decks, three mixers, like an elephant and a tin dolphin, whatever. But most of the time, when you actually go in the booth, they're not doing anything that you couldn't do on two decks or one mixer. So I think that's a bit of a fib when people say they're doing things like that. A lot of the things I try to do when I play, like all the remixing on the fly and all this kind of stuff, I've heard other DJs, quite big ones, say that they kind of do that as well. And then when I've seen them play, they're just kind of playing records or whatever, like, you know, from their Ableton. So I guess that's a fib as well. I think in this world, anyone will get away with anything that they can possibly get away with. You know, some of us, I wouldn't be happy with myself if I wasn't trying to do those things.
Everything is bullshit. We're not musicians. We're just people who are playing records. I remember Jeff Mills saying that he was the guy in the corner of the room playing the records, and people coming to, hey, can you play this and play that? I think it's just a bit more fancy today, just better dressed, getting more money, and playing for much more people, but still the same thing in the end. Who wouldn't?
Industry, because it has to make money, so it's not really about music. And I'm not gonna sit here and go like, oh, we're not about the money, because everybody who plays here gets paid. Actually, to be fair, I just walked in and I never really go to space, and I got in like earlier and Psychonauts playing, and it was fun because it was like all that good music I used to know from, like, it's really good, really, really nice.
Yeah.
It has to be, you only play well, or you only make people, I think you connect to people when you're having a great time DJing or playing music. And sometimes you do something and they don't understand it, or something they really, really get into it, or something people get really angry. But whenever you have a reaction like that, then it's great. The industry, I have to say, the whole... Because I don't know, the question is a bit... It can be broad, you know? Like, I don't think the industry is false. It's making money, so it's telling you that this is amazing and this is the new hype and this is... But I do think 2010, people have so many ways of finding out if something is bullshit or not.